mispronounce his name. He's got a very scientific name. So he is the guide for the village museum that tells about the different tribes, different culture. He will take you around here and explain you from, we will not have all the 120 tribes here or plus, but few that have been placed here, he will explain you and take you around, and at the end of the tour, he will bring you out here. So he will introduce himself. As I said, I don't want to mispronounce his name. After that introduction, you can go with him and do the tour. Thank you and welcome.
Okay, you are welcome. My name is Esbon Kashaga, a guide tour in this place. You are welcome, welcome. From where?
Yes,
oh wow, nice to meet you. So this is the village museum in Tanzania. It's a branch of National Museum in Tanzania. And here in Tanzania we have 6 museums. We have National Museum and the House of Culture. We have village museum, this one. Arusha, we have 2. Arusha Decoration Museum and Natural History Museum. But also we have Mwalimu Julius Kambarage Nyerere, representing the first president of the Republic of Tanzania, Mara region. And also we have Kalenga Iringa Museum in Tanzania, representing the Chief Mkwawa, who resisted with the Germans. So this is the branch of National Museum, which was established in 1966, and International Trade Fair, TANU Tanganyika Africa National Union. So officially it was opened to the public in 1967 with the 10 traditional houses. But until now we display 22 traditional houses. So 21 houses represent more than 120 tribes. And the one traditional house is the collective community. That is Waswahili. So we say Waswahili is not a tribe. Waswahili is the combination of collective community people from coastal area, starting from Lam, Mombasa, Zanzibar, and those Arabs who came here before for trade activities. So when they came in the coastal area here to find a job, they rented Swahili house. And this traditional house is categorized in 3 forms. So here we have banda. Banda, the roof is rectangular shape or V shape. And also we have msonge, which look like a cone shape and a round shape. And also we have tembe, which is flat the roof, and split by using clay soil mixing with cow dung, and plaster the wall. So I'm sure when you land in this area, it means you land in Tanzania at the same time to experience different culture of different ethnic group, more than 120 tribes. You are welcome to see.
Too many tribes.
Yeah. So we will see the traditional house inside, and the artifact or collections, but also we will see, we have also traditional dance, and after that we have also a curio shop. Here you can see after walking around. So you are welcome.
You can probably leave it in the bus.
About 95% of the population is Bantu, and also we have Nilotic is Maasai, so sometimes we call it Maasai warrior. So originally Maasai are from Egypt and Ethiopia, and they reach in Sudan the place called Khartoum. So from Khartoum, they pass in Sarah Desert and they reach Kenya. Therefore, from Kenya here, they spread here in Tanzania. That's why sometimes you say Masa is like a wedding. They migrate sometimes in Kenya, sometimes in Tanzania. And if today you not see the house of Maasai. The Maasai house is look like this. You see front of the roof and they split it by using clay soil mixing with cow dung. The poop of cow, the plaster in the wall. So it's not a permanent house, it's a temporary house. And it's called Manyata. It's split by women. So women are responsible to split this house. And because many of the Maasai are nomadic pastoralism. And but Maasai takes the fresh blood from the knob of the cow for drinks and for food. Same like a Gogo, central part of Tanzania, Dodoma. So Dodoma is the capital city of Tanzania. And the parliament of Tanzania is here in Dodoma. Those takes blood fresh from the cow for drinks and for food. The last one is Kushitik. Kushitik including Ilak. Among the Ilak, there is Sandawe and the Tindiga. And most of these Sandawe and Tindiga, we call them Azabe. Azabe, sometimes we call them Bushmen. They live here in Mbubu, Arusha district, and they Creek language. Like, I don't know how to Creek it well. So the Creek language. And in Tanzania, we speak more than 100 language. But we have, for instance, me, I'm Wihaya. I speak Kihaya. Sukuma speaking Kisukuma. Nyamwezi speaking Kinyamwezi. And the Konongo speaking Kikonongo. So these are different languages. Maybe let me talk about it. Okay, I will talk it later. Also, we have So the biggest tribe in Tanzania, we are more than 55 million of people. So the biggest tribe is Sukuma. Sukuma are located near to the shore of the Lake Victoria. This Lake Victoria is the second largest lake in the world, but first lake in Africa. And the current president of Tanzania, Dr. John Pombe Joseph Magufuli, is belong to this Sukuma. Sukuma is about 5.5 million of people compared to other tribes. And the second one is Haya. This is my tribe, Haya, Nyamwezi, as well as Makonde. These are more than 2 million of people. And the last one is Chaga from the southern land of Mount Kilimanjaro. You know the highest mountain in Africa?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So Mount Kilimanjaro, Chaga is more than 1 million of people. So I'm sure now you are going to walk across the country and to experience different culture of different ethnicity. More than 120 tribes. These are most of the house. That is Msonge, as I told you before, Msonge, which looks like a cone shape, the round shape, and which is, this is also Msonge, containing corridor, front, and this is Banda, which is the triangle shape or V shape. This is kind of Banda, and also Tembe is flat, the roof, this one. Now we have also African instrument music, which processes a plant melody when playing. And this traditional dance is called a xylophone. Yeah. So.
Yeah.
Okay. So also, we have displayed artifact here, which are used for hunting and for security purposes. This includes spear for hunting, and the fencing shelter, which is used for protecting arrows and the spear during a war. But also during those days, we couldn't have mass media, like radio, television, whatever. This trumpet was sounding like a mass media, and it was special for chief to invite people in the meeting. But it was sounding different according to the event. So everyone can know the event is good or bad when it's sounding. These are highly special for shaping tools, as well as used as a spear and a crab for beating thieves. Mostly it's used by Maasai, the way they work with it here. And then these are leather pouch, special for keeping and arrows during hunting and the war. Here is a dressing style representing the coast of people from the year in Salaam. The Muslims, Salaam. These are Muslims.
Yes.
Okay, what was this for?
Crab. Yeah, crab was one of the weapons used for beating the thief, especially the thief.
Hitting the animal?
No, for the animal, yes. The animal. Yeah, many Maasai keep animals, so they walk with it to protect themselves against thief and the government people.
Okay.
This one is a trap for fish. These are trap for fish, and the ears paddle, which support the movement of the boat. So they push water back up, then they allow boat to move forward. And the ear is for agriculture, and practice putting in caravage. This caravage is made for storage cereals like maize, beans, cassava, but also used for storage water, milk, and the local beer.
So it can carry liquid and dry?
Yes, liquid form. And the honey roll for the land, the farm, but the sickle for starting the grasses, and the maca tree, and the male slings. When they take cow far away, they tie to the neck of the cow. So when the cow is going far, they know the direction of the cow through the bear. So this water in the pistol for cow milk cereals, made flour for oil or garlic. Calabash for storage, but also these are best played for serving food for a large number of people, especially coastal area, Salaam here at Arusha. And then it has container for storage cereals. Like he has mortar for milking cow. And there's strainer for preferring local beer drinks, but these are coconut cheddar for coconut and coconut. Most people folk in coastal area here cannot eat food without mixing coconut. So it's very important. That's why you see that one, the coconut tree. And the traditional pot in my tribe, Ohio, we use traditional pot for storage food. And when someone is traveling far away, you take a head of leaf banana, then you put the banana back, so you cover with the banana back. So when someone is traveling far, you travel the food and the bottle all the time.
It stays right?
Yes. And these are more for saving liquid form, like the traditional beer. One whiskey and the for chaga they call it in bacon. Here you see artifact which is presented in the ceremonial. Like spoofu, it's really for selling local beer for chief. And the chief cannot speak with people without having walking stick in the spear with a traditional stool. So if you want to talk with people, you sit on the traditional stool and they pull the spear in front of him, then he can speak with the people. This is to show the power of the community. Yeah. According to the tradition, the custom of Skuma, they use snail shell. This snail shell, they put traditional medicine for curing disasters in India. So they believe that through this snail shell, we connect with ancestors, through the spirit of God, and then to know what is happening. Here is for traditional dance. They use masks for performing traditional dance, especially people from Mozambique, Makonde. So Makonde here, more than 1 million of people. As I said, the biggest tribe is Skuma. After Skuma, it's my tribe, Haya. And then actually, I can explain about the Haya because the house of Haya is far away. Maybe you can be tired or anything. So Haya, a bunch speaking from Kagera. Kagera is northwest part of Tanzania. It's a compound of three countries, Uganda, Rwanda, and Burundi. But the staple food is banana, and the coffee is for cash crop. But Haya, if you, here in Tanzania, you ask many professors around Tanzania, professional people, doctors, teachers, lawyers, engineering, you ask my tribe, Haya. Why Haya educated? Because during the colonial period, when the British and the Germans came, they passed in these three countries, Uganda, Rwanda, and Burundi. Then they settled in Kagera. So there, Kagera, they established school, seminary, hostel, church, and the men of the Haya was educated and civilized. But the men of the Haya is Protestant and the Roman Catholic. But the nature of the hire is to proud of themselves. So you can see a man is prouding himself. Say I'm an educated man, a senior civil servant, a great man, sometimes not. And in hire, if you want to marry hire, you need to have the same level of education of your wife. If you don't have the same level of education, they say, please just go and be prepared well. Then you come back. Means what? You need to go to study, then you come to get your wife. And if you have the same level, they say, please, you know, we take our daughter from standard one up to university. So we pay a lot of money. Are you ready to pay according to the same level of education of our daughter? If you can't afford, you go. So marriage is concerned, parents will decide. For instance, me, I get married, and during the wedding, I needed to introduce my wife, my family, apart of my wife. So how can I introduce my family apart of my wife? I'm a hire. So I introduce everyone with a professional way. I say, this is my daddy. She is a professor working in UK. So she came yesterday especially for this event. And this is my mommy. She is a lawyer working in embassy of somewhere. She came yesterday special for this event. And those who don't have professional work, I say, this is my brother and the other relatives, they are coming to support me. It's enough. Mm-hmm. Why? They don't have professional work. Mm-hmm. And the hire, if you meet a man who have a family, he can introduce everyone in his family. You can say, you are the visitor, maybe you are coming to visit us. So I say, I'm somebody, a professor or a doctor. You come, my wife, this is my wife, she's a lawyer, and you come, my son, this is my son, he's now engineering, and you, my daughter, come here, this is my daughter, she's now studying university or somewhere, and as you see, this is my house, and outside you can see a big car, Prado, that is the culture of the hire. Now, how does he know there? So here, you see, horn of cows, and are used for blowing through during performing traditional dance. So when they dance, especially Sukuma, the current president of Tanzania, they use this horn of cow, and when they blow it, they dance while having the they dance with the also snake, a python, while blowing this one. And these are translutes, which are used during performing traditional dance. They wear this leg, and here, that one they wear in the whiskey during performing traditional dance. Now we are going to see the traditional house, but most of the house, because many of them is broken because of rainfall.
Rainfall.